Zach.
Hey, what's up, Joe?
An amazing film. I love this film. We watched it over and over last night, my girlfriend and I and her daughter. Amazing job. First question I have for you, though, is what inspired you to tell a story about love and family through music?
Yeah, absolutely. And thank you, by the way, that means a lot to me. You know, from the beginning, I wanted to explore this idea of, I think all the stories that I tend to gravitate towards kind of explore the idea of recognizing the beauty in the world around you. It's kind of what Puddles was about as well. I think it's something that I often struggle with from my own vantage point. And I think that's where a lot of my story ideas come from, is from my own personal struggles in life. And this one in particular was about like me realizing that, hey man, I'm starting to get a little bit older. I'm starting to feel those changes. And what does that mean? And I was looking backwards at, you know, my younger self and kind of wishing I could have that again. And my wife is not like that at all. She's very live in the present. I can't wait to get older. Every birthday, she's on to the next one. And so is my mother. And thinking about kind of those different perspectives on aging, and looking at my grandparents and how one set, you know, sold their house and bought an RV and traveled the United States and went to all the national parks, and the other ones got an apartment and, you know, were pretty much sedentary in their older age. And so I really thought there was an interesting conflict there between, you know, basically my wife and I, a character who's kind of stuck in the past and is kind of it stuck in this kind of negative mentality, and someone who's living in the present and is enjoying their life.
It's so fascinating because like I've known my girlfriend for over 20 years now. Oh, and wow. It's so crazy about how much emotion you feel through these characters, even reflecting on your own life. But yeah. One thing that I loved about this also is that music is a universal language. And such a beautiful part of this piece. Now, how different is it animating a story timed to music opposed to timing one that's to spoken word?
You know, the actual animation process is not terribly different, because so much of what we do as animators is, you know, we're listening to that dialogue, we're listening to the rhythm of it, we're trying to find the rhythm of the shot. You know, we have to make sure things are in sync and timed properly. This is just a little bit different in that, you know, you're trying to hit specific notes on specific beats and things like that. But we also had amazing reference of Keone and Mari, you know, for everything. And so we had a really clear guide as to like what the intention is. And then our responsibility was really just trying to stay authentic to that dance and have a conversation about where we could push it further. Because it's animation, we could exaggerate it a little bit further, make things snappier, faster, jump higher, things of that sort. But still keep it grounded and make it feel like real dance.
I want to talk about that for a second, because you got the talented, amazing World of Dance champions and real life couple, Keone and Mari. How did that come together? And how did they participate in the creative process?
Sure. Yeah. So they were... them as an idea was part of my original pitch. You know, part of the pitch at the very beginning was, I'd love to create this world of dance where dance isn't something that you do, but just how everything is done. And I actually had kind of a supercut of clips of Keone and Mari as like a, here's what I think the world could feel like. And I just played, you know, basically all of their World of Dance clips and some YouTube clips and things like that. Just to kind of elicit that feeling of their style of dance and how they can tell stories and be both broad and small at the same time. And then, and so when the film got greenlit, pretty immediately, within a couple months of developing the film, we called them and asked if they were interested in coming in just to have a conversation. And I was amazed that they said yes. We pitched them the project and they loved it, thank God. And so they basically joined our creative team pretty much right away. And so we would show them the reels every time we cut together the storyboards. We would show it to them. We would talk about the characters. We'd get their notes. We'd talk about the dance. We'd talk about what they need from the music to tell Pinar. So we kind of had that whole circle going. And by the time we got the story kind of locked in, then we got the music and then relocked the story. And then we could kind of share it with them so that they could put in that final input of what the dance was.
That boardwalk scene towards the end there is so emotional. And Pinar, his amazing music is really, really featured there. Can you talk to me about the collaboration process working with him and finding the right sound for this for the short film?
Sure. It's a she.
I'm sorry.
No problem. But it was an interesting journey there too, because she came on really early on. We knew we wanted to do this, you know, kind of a soul funk feel. And she kind of just started with themes, you know, I think this could be cool. And we would just kind of give notes on that because it was kind of agnostic of story. And then at the very end, when we got to that point, you know, the kind of bench moment on the pier, you know, we wanted it to be really minimal. You know, that was kind of the conversation we had with her. Is we had all, you know, we want this big energy. And then in this moment, we kind of want nothing. If we could get away with absolutely zero, that'd be cool. But I wanted the music to feel as empty as art feels in that moment. And when she came back with just those like piano keys, it was like, oh, like just really cut you deep, you know? And so, and that the timing changed on that a few times and she had to, you know, make some adjustments, but yeah, she killed it in that section and the whole ending, the way she kind of brought the energy back in, the emotion back in at the end, had us in tears pretty much right away.
Puddles in rain. Tell me the significance of water to you.
I don't know, man. I grew up in the Midwest and, you know, I played outside a lot. I'm a huge, you know, I'm just a big kid in general. And so for puddles, it was all about kind of the childishness, the playfulness of playing in puddles. And so I think that came true in this story as well. You know, I pitched four stories. This is the only one that had rain in it, but it starts to look like I'm trying to make a trilogy of rain films. you know, for me, it was, I knew that I wanted to do a Fountain of Youth story. The rain felt like a really cool mechanism to be that fountain of youth and to be that magical element. But it also spoke to the youth of the world, them becoming young, playing in the rain, as well as the romanticism of the relationship building. Dancing in the rain is just like, I just don't know if there's anything more romantic than that. And so the combination of youth and romance, I think kind of, it just kind of made sense for me.
Now, one thing that my girlfriend picked up on, and I completely agree with this, is the film really speaks to aging and the state of mind that aging takes you. And also just getting out there and not having any kind of regret, especially with your loved ones trying to encourage you to get out there and do things. Can you talk to me about the state of mind and aging that's found in this film?
Yeah, she nailed it. Your girlfriend's perfect. That's... yeah, that really was the intention, is, you know, that idea that youth is a state of mind, that it's a decision to view yourself as old, therefore, because we associate old with being out of the picture, to step to the side, and it's a choice to not see the world that way, to not see yourself that way, and to not stop living your life and to stop recognizing what makes life beautiful. And again, you know, that's what my wife kind of brings for me, is that view of like, let's, and I think it's even a better message right now with everybody at home, you know, get up, get out, see the world, appreciate the beauty in it, and appreciate those around you that make your life special.
Now I want to go back to the dance side of this real quick.
Yeah.
How many different styles or genres of dance were incorporated in some of those scenes?
Well, it's interesting because that's why we chose Keone and Mari as well, is they have this really interesting and specific style of dance that kind of blends a lot of different styles together. It's what I love about their dance, is it feels very modern and fresh. You know, they have a lot of elements of hip hop, but they also incorporate a lot of contemporary. There was a little bit of like jazz that was kind of incorporated in there as well. In the backgrounds, we encouraged them, because we shot a lot of reference for the background characters as well. And we threw in a ballet is back there. There's you know, popping and locking. There's we just kind of said, just go for it. I hit play on the music and we just kind of let them dance around. And you know, for different stuff, it's like, okay, you're walking, you're a couple, you're whatever. And we just kind of let them feel the music and just go with it. So we tried to incorporate as many styles of dance as possible to really make it feel like a world of dance.
Well, Zach, look, you, this is what filmmaking is all about, is bringing out emotion in a visual spectrum. And that's exactly what you did. So phenomenal job. I love the film. Thank you so much for your time, man. I truly appreciate it.
I really appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Take care.
All right. See ya.